telephone rang about a quarter till nine. She heard his voice on the other end of the line. She wondered what was wrong this time. She never knew what his calls might bring. With a cowboy like him, it could be anything. And she always expected the worst in the back of her mind. He said, "It's cold out here and I'm all alone. Didn't make the short go again, and I'm coming home. I know I've been away too long. I never got a chance to ride a car, and I know this rodeo's been hard on us all. But I'll be home soon, and honey, is there something wrong?" She said, "Don't bother coming home. By the time you get here, I'll be long gone. There's somebody new, and he sure ain't no rodeo man." He said, "I'm sorry it's come down to this. There's so much about you that I'm gonna miss. But it's alright, baby, if I hurry, I can still make Cheyenne. Gotta go now, baby, if I hurry, I can still make Cheyenne." He left that phone dangling off the hook, then slowly turned around and gave it one last look. Then he just walked away. He aimed his truck toward that Wyoming line. With a little luck, he could still get there in time. And in that Cheyenne wind, he could still hear her say, she said, "Don't bother coming home. By the time you get here, I'll be long gone. There's somebody new, and he sure ain't no rodeo man." He said, "I'm sorry it's come down to this. There's so much about you that I'm gonna miss. But it's alright, baby, if I hurry, I can still make Cheyenne. Gotta go now, baby, if I hurry, I can still make Cheyenne." She never knew what his calls might bring. With a cowboy like him, it could be anything. And she always expected the worst in the back of her mind.